I know not if he represents the greatest threat or greatest hope for the future of the Imperium. I only pray we stop him before we find out. The ancient warriors of the Legiones Astartes would leave an imposing legacy to be inherited by their successors. Legendary martyrs, champions, and leaders would shape their forebears' future deeds in matters of honor, combat doctrine, and objectives. Yet one individual would hearken a veil of shadows impregnable to even his kin. For today, we shall elucidate the schemes of a singular Astartes, shrouded in duplicity and mystery. The bearer of the ancient Calibanite title, known only as Cypher. To understand the deeds of Cypher, it is imperative to understand the history of Caliban and the First Legion, the Dark Angels. Lionel Johnson, Primarch of the Emperor and Lord of the First Legion, would be discovered upon the world of Caliban. Orphaned among the beasts of the Death World, the feral youth would survive alone until his fateful encounter with a Knight of the Order, Sar Lufa. Raised by his new foster father, the Lion of the Forest would grow to become a genius military strategist and indomitable warrior. Inducted into the Knight Order, the Lion, with Lufa's aid, would orchestrate a crusade to drive the beasts of Caliban to extinction to allow for his populace to flourish. Succeeding in their purge of the native wildlife, the Knight Order would increase in number until its ascension as the most powerful knight organization of the planet. Many senior officers would comprise the Order of Caliban, with one such individual given the title of Cypher. Tasked with upholding and maintaining their traditions, the Cypher of the Order of Caliban would renounce his old name and assume the mantle of his responsibility, concealed behind cloak and hood. Forbidding any to revive or acknowledge their kin's former identity, the custodian of the Order's disciplines, laws, and customs would ensure each knight's adherence to the standards befitting their rank. Officiating ceremonies and advising the inner circle of the Order during their campaigns, the First Lord Cypher would be an elderly knight whom would advise the Lion during the crusade to end the beasts of Caliban. With Caliban's conquest of their homeworld, the Emperor of Mankind would reunite with his long-lost son and install the Lion as the leader of the First Legion, soon to be known as the Dark Angels. Perishing in the subsequent years of the Legion's renewal, a new Lord Cypher would be appointed. The newly installed Lord Cypher would serve his Legion for several years, yet be destined to be relegated to garrison his homeworld of Caliban in the wake of their compliance of the peoples of Sarosh. The planet of Sarosh would stall in their compliance decreed by the Master of Mankind, much to the chagrin of the White Scars Legion, tasked with facilitating their alliance. The Dark Angels would relieve the 5th Legion as their 4th Expeditionary Fleet mustered in orbit. Lionel Johnson would attempt to hasten the proceedings of the Saroshi's induction into the Imperium, yet discover the reason for their delayed compliance. The Saroshi people worshipped pagan gods in the image of the then unknown ruinous powers, and attempt to assassinate the Primarch of the First by smuggling an explosive aboard the flagship of the Dark Angels, the Invincible Reason. Sar Lufa would discover the Saroshi's deception, yet diver in his responsibility to dispose of the deadly cargo. The Dark Angels' librarian, Sahariel El-Zarias, would witness his superior's failure to act, yet not divulge his insight unto the Lion. The seeds of his deception would cost the Dark Angels time, and though the explosive would be ejected into space, its detonation would damage the Invincible Reason and cost several needless Astartes' lives to be lost. With his foster father's lapse in loyalty, the Lion would order Sar Lufa and a detachment of his Legion to garrison their homeworld and train new recruits to reinforce the Legion. Alienated from his foster son and liege, Lufa would stew in his resentment as the Great Crusade waged on and glories would be won by the Lion. Alongside the young Lord Cypher and Librarian of the Dark Angels, Zahariel, Lufa would recruit and train a new generation of Astartes into the First Legion, as the Horus Heresy waged, and the Dark Angels' fleet endured losses during the conflict. Advised closely by the Lord Cypher, Lufa would plot to usurp the command of the Lion and stage a rebellion to cast off Caliban's allegiance to the Imperium. Working with the mysterious Watchers in the Dark, alongside the Archbetrayer of Caliban, the Lord Cypher would be confronted by Lufa's lieutenant, Zahariel, for his actions as a double agent within their ranks. The Lord Cypher would be slain by order of Zahariel, with the Librarian renouncing his own name in order to assume the mantle of Lord Cypher for himself at the behest of Lufa. Warmaster Horus Lupercal's attempt to usurp the Emperor would fail, and the forces of Chaos would retreat into the roiling tides of the Eye of Terror. Yet the ruinous powers still held a champion in their clutches, capable of renewing their plots to destroy the Imperium anew. Lufa. Lionel Johnson would arrive to reinforce Holy Terror, too late to prevent the Emperor from being interred upon the Golden Throne. Stricken with guilt, shame, and grief for his failure, the Lion would lead his forces to give chase to the fleeing traitor legions. Yet the Dark Angels had incurred heavy casualties during the years of the Horus Heresy, and would need fresh troops to enable their purge of heresy across the stars. Returning to Caliban, the Lion's fleet would be fired upon by the planetary defenses of his homeworld, and in an act of fury, the Lion would deploy the full might of his legion to confront their foes. Descending upon Caliban as its once proud bastions burned, the Lion would lead his forces to confront Sarlufa within the fortress of Alderuk. During the battle, the Seneschal of the Dark Angels, Corswain, would confront the new Lord Cypher, Zahariel. The two angels would duel, with accounts of both Corswain and the interrogated Lufa stating that Zahariel had been slain by the Dark Angels' champion. The Lion would battle the now chaos-empowered Lufa and be struck down by the might of his once noble mentor. Lufa would grieve at his actions and reject the gifts of the ruinous powers, yet in his act of defiance, reap the wrath of the Dark Gods. The Watchers in the Dark would retrieve the Lion's body in secret as the Dark Angels arrested the forlorn and raving Lufa. Caliban would be torn apart by a violent warp storm, birthed by the Chaos Gods, as their last remnant of treachery denied their patronage. Corswain would assume the title of the first Supreme Grand Master of the now Dark Angels chapter, and outline the continual interrogation of Lufa for each of his kin to follow in his footsteps. Caliban's remnants would be reforged into the vast void ship, the Rock, and serve as the headquarters of the Dark Angels, whilst the Lion lay dormant deep within the most secret chambers of Alderuk. The Dark Angels would pledge to hunt down the surviving fallen angels as they fled reprisal, a task which would last for 10 millennia before an event which would absolve their legion's shame. With the fall of Caliban, Cypher would remain at large across Imperial space. Eluding capture for 10 millennia, Cypher has acted less as a culprit and more a herald of destruction and misery to any segmentum he journeys. Rarely the instigator, yet always the cause of violence in his dealings, Cypher leaves little to no clues to his future whereabouts as he fulfills his own objectives and tasks throughout the galaxy. Sought by both Imperium and Chaos forces to glean information from his capture, Cypher has few allies and innumerable foes. The Dark Angels, in their relentless pursuit of the fallen angels, have recorded his death on several occasions, only to receive new reports on his activities. Escaping from the most deadly of enemies, such as the Red Corsairs, Cypher is one of the most enigmatic of foes of both the Imperium and its contemporaries. A legend among the disparate ranks of the fallen, the Dark Angels would surmise Cypher to be a veteran of the fallen angels, yet find no evidence of his prior rank, name, or deeds. Leading no war bands, nor members of the Fallen Angel, Cypher is a truly independent being, rarely siding with any factions during the millennia following the fall of Caliban. His ability to escape impossible odds would have some speculate that Cypher's identity is not even that of the progeny of the Lion. Adherents of the Hydra, the Alpha Legion, would claim that only their Primarch, Omegon, could be capable of such legendary deeds of espionage and infiltration alone. Impeccable in his timing to wreak havoc or salvation during the most critical of campaigns, to call Cypher a catalyst would be an understatement. Changing the outcomes of entire planetary wars with his intervention, Cypher has assassinated planetary governors, cult leaders, inquisitors, and even Astartes chapter masters during his many missions of unknowable intent. In the span of half a century, Cypher would slay both the Overlord of the Chaos Warband, the Flawless Host, and Supreme Grand Master of the Angels of Absolution, Bartholomew Loxlaw, leading to further confusion as to his true allegiances. His incredible lifespan and legendary deeds causing some to proclaim that he bears the patronage of some unknown power. Yet none can ascertain if such a being would be benevolent or malevolent. Wearing an ancient suit of Artificer armor and wielding a pair of mastercrafted plasma and bolter pistols, the mysterious figure of the Fallen Angels carries a blade of unknown origin across his back. Rumored to be the Lion's Sword, once wielded by the Primarch of the First Legion, Cypher in all his sightings across the stars has never drawn it from its scabbard. Others speculate the weapon to be the Sword of Lufa, the fell blade responsible for their Primarch's wounding and supposed death by the arch-traitor, while some even believe it to be one of the eponymous Heavenfall blades of the Dark Angels. Seeking an audience with the Master of Mankind upon the Golden Throne, should Cypher succeed in his quest, speculation abounds as to the intent the sword burdens. Some say that should Cypher succeed in meeting the Emperor, he shall plunge the blade into the heart of the Master of Mankind and hearken a new era of darkness with the light of the Emperor extinguished for eternity. Others claim Cypher shall kneel before the Emperor and offer the blade as an act of penance for his past deeds to achieve redemption. With others believing that should the weapon in fact be the Lion's Sword, Cypher shall entrust it once more to the Primarch of the First, should he return to the Imperium. Despite the Dark Angel's fervent hatred of Cypher, his actions have enabled several revelations to be discovered by their ranks. Uncovering corruption within the ranks of the Imperium's hierarchies, the location of fallen angels surrendered to the powers of the warp, or potential worlds draw promising recruits to their number. Whether such fortunes are genuine acts of contrition or distraction is unknown. Intervening during the Dark Angels' deployment of Red Star's campaign against a sizable Orc War, the Dark Angels would prove unable to defeat the Orc Warlord, Zogax the Great. Yet with Cypher's intervention, utter catastrophe would be averted, despite the death of the chapter's then Supreme Grand Master, Alokhen. Zogax would attempt to claim the chapter relic, the Lion's Helm, yet for his attempt, lose his hand to a blast from Cypher's plasma pistol. Felled by Cypher's bolt pistol, Zogax would be slain, with Cypher dragging Alokhen's corpse to a nearby trench. Ensuring the chapter's relics to be out of the reach from the Orcs, Cypher would retreat from the pursuing Dark Angels. Seen by some as a freedom fighter of the oppressed, Cypher's deeds would, despite their seeming proclivity to ensure the survival of the Dark Angels, earn no favor from the Sons of the Lion. Attributed titles of varying legitimacy, Cypher would be proclaimed as the Robed Rogue, Savior of Praxis, and Voice of the Emperor by the populaces of disparate planets. Regularly orchestrating rebellions across Imperial space to enable his plans, Cypher confounds Imperial officials in his seemingly supernatural ability to embolden the dispossessed. His mastery of manipulation, capable of earning unbreakable loyalty by his fallen brethren, the Dark Angels are never able to discern viable intelligence from his irregularly appointed bodyguards. Though many of the fallen abhor the acts of Cypher, the ranks of the betrayers of Caliban are as varied and misaligned as the notches of a battle-worn blade. aligning with demon princes, imperial guard regiments, mechanicum carders, space marine chapters, chaos lords, and even primarchs, Cypher has allied himself with any capable of fulfilling his own objectives. Yet his last known alliance to the Avenging Sun hearkens a new dawn for the Dark Angels and their fallen brethren. During 999.M41, Rabute Gilliman, Primarch of the Ultramarines, would be revived upon his homeworld of Macragge. Lain dormant for 10 millennia, the Lord of Ultramar would awaken to a galaxy bereft of its former glory. Assembling a vast fleet destined to venture to the Throne World, the Terran Crusade of Rabute Gilliman would traverse the stars in the Avenging Sun's mission to reunite with the Emperor. Trapped within the maelstrom by the greater demon of Sinch, Kairos Fateweaver, Gilliman's forces would be captured and imprisoned within a Blackstone fortress under the command of the Red Corsairs. With the intervention of Cypher, Gilliman would be freed, and with the aid of the Harlequin Shadowseer, Silandri Veilwalker, the unlikely alliance of Xenos and Renegade would escape the Blackstone Fortress and clutches of Chaos. Cypher would demand an audience with the Emperor for his aid, to which Rabute Gilliman would accept. Remaining with the Terran Crusade during their traversal to Holy Terra, Cypher would further advise the Primarch of the 13th in their navigation of the Eldar Webway until their arrival to the Moon of Luna. Confronted by the Primarch of the Thousand Suns, Magnus the Red, Gilliman and the Terran Crusade would face the sorcerers of the Ruinous Powers. Victorious in battle, Cypher would accompany Gilliman to the Imperial Palace of Terra to convene with the Emperor. Yet Gilliman would betray Cypher, unwilling to allow such an enigmatic figure to meet the Master of Mankind should even a shred of danger be posed by his presence. Ordering the custodian guard to arrest Cypher, the fallen angel would be imprisoned within the elaborate dungeons of the Emperor's guardians. Yet in a mere matter of hours, Cypher would escape. His objective to meet the Emperor denied, the Spectre of Caliban would seek a new means to achieve his objective. Renewed with the return of a loyal son of the Emperor to the fold, the Imperium would begin its great task of once more reclaiming their former glory. The Indomitas Crusade would see the Avenging Sun reclaim countless worlds and reinforce the waning strength of the chapters of the Astartes with fresh recruits, sired from the genius of Archmagos, Belisarius Call. Yet while the Imperium burgeoned anew, Cypher would remain a constant target of the Unforgiven chapters, now aware of his intervention during the Terran Crusade. Reinforced by the Primaris Marines bequeathed by Rabute Gilliman, the Unforgiven chapters would be emboldened in their endless quest to persecute the Fallen. Yet with the dawn of the 42nd millennium, new threats would seek to humble the descendants of the First Legion. Angron, Primarch of the World Eaters Legion, would return to the Material Realm, allied with the Warmaster of Chaos, Abaddon the Despoiler, and his new ally, Vashtor the Archiphane. The Rock would be besieged by the forces of Chaos and wreak a heavy toll upon the Dark Angels. Azrael, the Supreme Grand Master of the First, would lead the defense of the Dark Angels' Fortress Monastery and hold the line against the overwhelming tides of Chaos. Yet deep within the bowels of Alderuk, the long-dormant Primarch of the First would awaken. After 10 millennia of slumber, under the care of the Watchers in the Dark, Lionel Johnson would rise once more to face the champions of the Ruinous Powers. Driving back the invasion of the Rock and banishing Angron once more into the Warp, the Lion would renew his legion and absolve several fallen angels to be brought back into the fold. Commanding the Unforgiven and Risen Angels in his campaign to purge the galaxy of the taint of Chaos, the Lion embarks upon the greatest crusade fought by the inheritors of the First Legion in 10,000 years. Though the part Cypher will play in his reborn Primarch's deeds remains to be seen. For the hatred of Cypher runs deep within the core of the Unforgiven chapters, and it is unclear if even the favor of the Lion is enough to absolve the fallen angel from the enmity of his brethren. He weaves in and out of my vision. I see one who is many. I see they who will test the unforgiven. In one hand he carries hope, in the other despair. I speak of Cypher. He is coming closer all the time. This has been a tale of the Great Imperium of Man, read by the Remembrancer. Cypher remains an elusive individual to the Imperium at large. With even the fragment of records available to the Emperor's historians corrupted in mistruths, misdirection, and falsity. Yet it is the hope of this Remembrancer that Cypher shall aid the Imperium in his future endeavors with the favor of his Primarch. For should he side with more malevolent allies, woe betide any who shall stand in his way.